Hello, Guy.
Hello.
How are you today?
Very well, thank you.
Okay. Before we start, I have to introduce you about this gym, okay? And in case of fire alarm go off, okay, you got to follow the fire exit, which is in that corner, that door. Go down outside, don't worry about your belonging, okay? And if you need first aid there, at the reception, you have any question, you can ask them, get medicine, plaster or anything, okay? And the fitness instructor wearing black clothes walking around, you can ask them question. Okay, telephone, anything at the reception. If you need wet wipe to use with the machine, they provide it just over there, and also water. Okay, we're going to do a few exercise. We start with a warm up first with a cross trainer. Okay, then we're going to do pre-exercise stretch. We're going to do around here a few exercise before we go to our cardiovascular exercise, which is recumbent bike over there. Okay, with warm up, why do we need to warm up? Okay, to increase the temperature, body temperature, increase your heart rate, and get your muscle ready for exercise. Also, to do warm up, it will reduce the thickness in your joint, of the liquid in your joint. So make your body better doing exercise.
Okay.
Okay, and shall we start?
Yes.
Okay. So this is a cross trainer machine, okay? And, okay, to step in cross trainer machine, please stand over there. Okay, good. Okay, we hold on a static handle first. Put your feet on the lower step here and come across and walking naturally, the screen will start. Okay, what you have to do is you have to maintain nice neutral spine, looking forward, hips, knee, ankle alignment. Okay, keep your body stepping over nice and neutral. With a warm up, we just keep moving. Usually warm up we do about 5 to 10 minutes, but for the video we're going to make it shorter, okay? And with the target on the warm up, we're going to look for the 40 RPM, so you can see it from over here. Okay, when you're ready, you can start grabbing on this moving handle, okay? Cross trainer machine is a machine utilized all over body muscles, okay? That's it. Maintain neutral spine, keep looking forward. Can you walk around and have a look? Okay? Good, okay. Now, static handle and step out. Okay? While you're doing exercise, I'm gonna ask you RPE level. What is RPE level? It's a rating of perceived exertion. Okay, so if you are sitting on the couch, we call it RPE level 1, very comfortable.
Okay.
And if you do hard work, the maximum heart rate is maximum work hardest you can is number 10.
Okay.
So maximum exertion.
Okay.
If you feel work in the middle, like not hard, not too easy, is number 5.
Okay.
When you do exercise, I ask that, and you tell me the level of RPE level. Okay, step in, please. That's it. Hold on static. Step up and move your feet forward. That's it. Neutral spine. Maintain neutral spine, hip, knee, ankle alignment. Keep looking forward. When you're ready, feel comfortable. You can hold on the static, the moving handle. Okay, good. Okay, keep moving. That's it. On the first minutes, just nice and slow like that, correct? With the warm up, we aim onto RPM 40, as I said before, okay? Maintain RPM 40 around 2 minutes and then cool down for 1 minute. Very good, guy. That's it. Well done, that's good. Keep moving, nice. Okay, now how do you feel? What is your RPE level?
It's gonna be 3 to 4, something like that.
Yeah, that's correct. We do 3 to 4 for 1 minute, and then on the second and third minutes, we aim on the warm-up target, which is 4. RPE should be around 4.
Okay.
So work a little bit harder on the second and third minutes. So you're coming toward the second and third minutes.
Yep.
Okay, so that's good. Okay, keep moving. Okay. Maintain neutral spine, hip knee ankle alignment correctly. Breathing naturally, and yeah, increase your movement a little bit. And if you need to put an effort level up, you can do that too. Okay, RPM should be around 40. Yes, that's right. So maintain that level for around 2 minutes. Good job. So what is your RPE level now?
Must be 4
right now. Okay, yeah, good, that's correct. Not too hard, don't go too more than this. Just maintain this for 2 minutes. One more minute, and then we're going to cool down. Warm up, utilize whole body muscle with this machine is great for warm up. If you come along to the gym on your own, before you start to do cardio exercise, warm up your body, warm up your joints with this exercise is good, okay? Do around, usually if you do on your own, should be around 5 to 10 minutes. And the RPM 40, aim on RPM 40, okay? Now, I think it's enough for the target zone. Just cool down now. You just bring yourself a little bit lower. Yeah, resistance lower. Okay. And maintain that low speed until coming to stop. About 1 minute is enough, okay? Don't rock your body side to side. You did really, really, really good, guy. Good position. Good posture. Okay. How's your RPE for this cool down?
Yeah, it's getting lower now.
Yeah. Okay, good. And coming to stop, please calm down. Yeah, that's it. And grab hold on the static handle. Yeah, and step out. Perfect.
Okay.
Yeah, how do you feel? Nice?
Yeah.
Nice?
Yeah,
okay, a bit warm up.
Warm.
Yeah, good. Okay, before we go to the cardio piece, we have to do stretch before our body cool, a few stretch, okay? First, we're going to get quadricep stretch.
Okay.
It's the lower part of the body, your legs here are quad, okay? So what you have to do is hold on balance on here or grab hold on something for balance, okay? And then try to grab on your foot over your shoelace, okay? And put your knees down under your hips, yeah? Like that, okay? Your support knee are like slightly soft and hold it there for 10 seconds. Is that okay? Understand?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. And then do the other side, please, try. Okay, push your, yeah, soft knee, support knee, soft knee, push it down under your hips, hold it there for 10 seconds. You feel the stretch on your quads?
Yes.
Good. Okay. Now let go of your legs and chin to the other side. That's it. Hold it there for 10 seconds. Correct. Well done. That's it. Very good. Okay, let's go of your legs now. We're going to move on to the other stretch, which is hamstring stretch. What you have to do is step forward, okay? You keep your back leg straight, your toes and your heels are on in line, okay? Now, bend your knee forward a little bit, okay? So you can feel the stretch on your hamstring at your back and keep holding it for 10 seconds. You okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, come over here, please. Guy, come over here. Yeah. Just like this angle. That's it. That's it. Step over. So the front heel in line with the back toes, okay? Now, keep your back leg straight. And then bend your knees over. Make sure that the knee doesn't go beyond your ankle, okay? And can you feel the stretch on the hamstring now?
Yeah.
Hold it there for 10 seconds. Well done, that's it. Okay, good. Okay, stop now, come back. Do the same thing to the other legs. Well done. The main thing is you don't want to damage your knee joint, so don't go beyond your ankle. That's it. Hold that 10 seconds, and that's it. Come back when you're ready.
Okay.
Okay, with the stretch, you shouldn't feel painful.
Okay.
You should feel a little bit tension, but like feeling stretch, uncomfortable, but not painful, okay? So next one, let me check. Next one, we're going to do trapezius and trapezius stretch and pectoral stretch. Okay, for trap is the muscle, upper body muscle over here, okay? What you have to do is, please stand over there so you can see what I'm doing. Just go back a little bit. Yeah, that's it. So you clasp your hand together, okay? Now you're going, in front of you, you're going to put it through your shoulder like this, okay? Soft knees, okay? Press your core and put it through your shoulder. To maximize the stretch, you look down and hold it there for 10 seconds, just like this. You can see on the side. Soft knee, brace your core, push it through in front of you, through your shoulder. Keep your elbow slightly bent. Like that, and maximize the stretch with... Put your neck, yeah, like that. Okay, slightly bent on your elbow, and maximize the stretch by folding, yeah, that's it, look down. Hold it there for 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Well done, guy. Relax. Okay, that's trapezius stretch. And then pectoral stretch. Okay, with the pectoral stretch, it's basically chest, your chest. Okay, so what you have to do is you clap your hand behind you, okay? Soft knee, okay? And rest your hand up, but don't bend, lean over, okay? So rest your hand up, and to maximize this stretch, you just deep inhale. And you're gonna have to feel, you will feel the stretch over across your chest. And hold it there for 10 seconds.
Okay,
try please. That's it, soft knees. Okay, and clasp your hand behind you and rest it. Deep inhale to maximize the stretch and hold it there for 10 seconds. Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, relax. Okay, 4 already stretch. Now we're going to do adductor stretch and deltoid and tricep, which is will be upper body. Adductor is an inner thigh. Okay, please, can you step over there? Okay, so what you have to do is you have the best legs pointing forward, and you take a last step, the toe go on 45 degrees, okay? Now bend this leg, left leg over, but don't let your knee go over your ankle, you're going to feel the stretch on the base knee, but inside here, inside your legs. Hold it there for 10 seconds. Do the same thing to the other side. Got it? Okay, now, yeah, last step to the side. Okay, please, can you stop? Not too close to the machine. That's it. Okay, and lean forward, okay? You will feel a stretch on the inner thigh. Make sure your knee doesn't go over your ankle. Don't lean too much on your leg, please. Just lean forward. That's it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now come up and do the same thing to the other side. Okay, can you feel the inner thigh stretch? Yeah, that's it. That's your adductor. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come up, okay? For the next stretch, it will be deltoid stretch, okay? Upper body, okay? Your deltoid here, your shoulder basically. So bring your arm across your chest, okay? And use your forearm to push on the elbow against your body, push it in toward your body, and hold it there for 10 seconds. You will feel the stretch on your shoulder deltoid. Okay, bring across, okay, push it forward toward yourself, okay? Yep. That's it. Can you feel the stretch? Okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax. Okay, now do the same thing to the other side. Okay, good. Relax. Now trapezius stretch, tricep stretch, okay? So bring your arms over and fold your hand, touch your back, okay? Now the free hand, push your arms back, okay? Avoid pushing it through your elbow, okay? Just like that, and hold it there for 10 seconds. Okay, can you stand? Yeah, that's it. Okay, good. That's it. Hold it there for 10 seconds. Okay, that's it. Good job. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax. And now do the same thing to the other side. Avoid pushing on your elbow. That's it. That's fine. You should feel uncomfortable, but not hurt, okay? That's it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, relax. Okay, you feel better now?
Yeah.
Okay, feel stretched now. We should go to our cardio exercise now, okay? I'm going to move the camera a little bit. Okay, this is a recumbent bike, okay? Recumbent bike, you can, it utilize lower body, but it's a good piece for cardio exercise, okay? What you have to do is take a seat, okay? So this, we adjust the seat when we stretch the legs, shouldn't be too stretched, don't lock your knee, should be slightly bend on your knees, okay? So we're going to move this seat slightly forward. Use the lever here on your side, here or here, okay? And then move forward. Now I can reach the paddle. This knee should be in 90 degree, okay? And the stretch knee should be slightly bent, okay? Remain 3-point contact, okay? Feet, back, and your head, okay? I'm going to start moving now, okay? I keep looking, nice neutral spine. You put your hand wherever you like, basically, but if you put here, your hand here, it will utilize your heart rate. You can check your heart rate, okay? Now, cardio exercise usually take about 20, 30 minutes, even 40 for somebody, okay? But with the video, we're going to do just let's go for 10 minutes, okay? Cardio exercise we aim on the target zone, we aim to reach RPM around 70 RPM. Okay, you can check the speed RPM on the screen. You can increase the effort level 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, depends how you feel. Okay, and keep moving. You have to just maintain position, keep you looking forward, neutral spine, hip knee ankle alignment. Yeah, you can walk across to have a look this side, please, if you like, in a different plane. You understand?
Yes.
Okay. Would you like to try now?
Yep.
Okay, let's go for it. Okay. Now hold on static. Bring yourself out. Okay? That's it. Okay. Now hold up the lever and push it back. Yeah, slightly bend on your stretch leg, slightly bend on your knee. The other knee is like 90 degrees bend. Okay. Hold on the static. Yeah, that's it. On the handle, keep moving. Yeah, increase the effort level if you want. The RPM should be in the target zone, RPM should be around 70. Okay? But slowly graduate. Don't worry. Don't worry to reach RPM 70 now. Just come slowly. So that cardio exercise should separate into three zones. First is like a pause resting zone, so warm up, build up your body. And then target zone is when you're working on your RPM 70. And we stay there for the video, we stay there for about 4 minutes. Then we come down, cool down, let's say cool down, and bring the speed down.
Okay.
Now I'm going to have to ask you RPE level after this, okay? I'm gonna ask you RPE level 3 times when it's cool, warm up, target zone, and cool down. Okay, okay. Keep going. First 2 minutes in the warm up section. Okay, remember when you do it on your own, the warm up, cardio should be around 20 to 30 minutes. Same thing, build up, target zone, and cool down. Don't jump out when you are RPMs on the RPM 70. Okay. Now, very good, nice neutral spine, hip knee ankle alignment. Very good, guy. Keep going. How do you feel? You okay?
Yes.
Good. Now I'm gonna have to ask your RPE level on this build up zone. How is it?
It's about 4.
4, that's perfect, yeah. That's correct. Yeah, 4 is what you aim for on the build up section, okay? Keep going for 1 more minute, please. Okay, now we start to build up to our target zone, which is RPM about 70, 80, okay? Keep going. How is the effort level, okay? Level 3, you feel okay with that? Okay, add a bit more. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, slowly up. Slowly up, no hurry, keep going. Now you feel you okay?
Yeah, it's getting hard now.
Good, good. Keep going. 1 more minute. Well done, guy. Good performance. Keep going. Well done. Maintain the speed at RPM 70. That's what you're doing, right? Okay, good, good. That's your target zone on the cardio exercise. So how is your RPE? How would you rate your RPE now?
Harder now.
Pardon?
Harder now. Like
harder
that.
Now. Good.
Six,
yeah.
Seven.
Six, seven. Okay. Yeah. Try to increase the speed a little bit harder. Make it like 7 to 8. Okay? 7 to 8. Okay. And do it one more minute. Maintain neutral spine, hip knee ankle alignment. Good job, guy, good job. Well done. I can see you increase the speed up. Good. Maintain the 70 to 80 RPM. How's your RPE now?
Definitely 7.
7. Good. Coming toward 8. Good. Very good. Very good. Okay, this last minute of the target zone. And then we're going to start to slow down. Can you do it?
Yeah, I can do it.
Yes, well done. Yes, you can. Good job as well. Do really well as well. Well done. Okay, now calm down now, slow down. Okay, we're going to cool down zone, which is around, aim to slowly, gradually come down to 40 and then finally stop within, for the video, just within this 1 minute, okay? Very good, very good. Down, down. How's your RPM on the cool down zone?
My RPE is...
Oh, sorry, RPE. yeah. Keep going down.
It's getting lower now, it's not so difficult. So it's more like back to 4 again.
Yeah, good, good. Okay. Okay, back to 4. Well done. That's it. Very similar to build up. Okay. Okay, I think it's enough. Yeah, when you're ready, slow down to stop. When you come out, please hold on static static handle and step out. Okay. How do you feel?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah?
Yeah. Good. Okay, are you ready to move on to another exercise?
Definitely.
Okay, let's move on together then. I'm going to grab my camera. Okay. We're going over there, we're going to do some resistance training. Okay. Okay, first we're going to do leg press then. Leg press. And then... So, this is a leg press machine. Utilize lower body muscles, okay? Gastrocnemius, hamstring, quadricep and glute.
Okay.
Okay, lower body muscles, okay? Now, let me show you. So step onto the machine. Okay. And put your feet up. The toe should be in line level with your eyes here, okay? Maintain 3-point contact, okay, in terms of feet, your back, your head, okay? A neutral spine, okay? The knee should be 90 degree flexion on your knees.
Okay.
Actually, I'm going to move the camera
sure.
to this side. Because, so you can see. Okay, that's better. Yeah, step into the machine. Sorry, start again. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, and put your feet here. A 90 degree angle on your knees. You hold it here, okay? Check the weight. Okay. And push. And when you push, it should be slightly flexion on your knees still, okay? You shouldn't lock your knees, you damage your joints, okay? And when you release, come toward here, shouldn't bang on the weight and then go back up again. Now, nice neutral spine, maintain hip, knee, ankle alignment. Inhale as you come, push up. Oh, sorry, inhale as you come down and exhale as you push up. Okay, like that. Is that okay? Would you like to try now? Yeah, walk around, have a look in a different angle. Shouldn't bang on the weight as you come down here, as you go down. And push it up, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Maintain neutral spine, hip, knee, ankle alignment, just like that. Don't lock on your knees as you push up, okay? Now it's your turn, okay. Now if you need to move the seat back and forward, hold up the first, put your feet here and hold it up and then push it out and all in.
Okay.
Okay? But make sure your feet have to stay here first. Okay, let's try. Okay. Feet first, please. That's it, and then move. Yeah, that's it. So level your toes. Yeah, your toe level with your eyes. The angle on your knee should be 90 degree. That's it. Closer. Yeah, that's it. That's it. That's better. Now change the weight. Maybe a little bit heavier than me. Maintain 3-point contact in terms of your feet, your back, your head.
Okay.
Push up, exhale. And inhale as you come down. That's it, well done. When you come down, please avoid banging on the weight. That's it, push it up. Utilize glute, hamstring, quadricep, gastrocnemius. Lower body exercise, that's it. Look in front of you. Maintain nice concentric, eccentric, very good. Okay, we do it, four more. Four, okay, three, two, one. Well done, guy, that's it, relax. Okay, you can sit there on.
Okay.
Yep. I'm going to ask you the RPE. How was your RPE level there?
That's quite high. Actually. Maybe 7 or 8.
7 or 8? Yes, yeah, that's really good. Okay. So we're going to do 10 more.
Okay.
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 Now please start. Remember, hip, knee, ankle alignment, 3-point contact, neutral spine. And exhale. Okay. Inhale. Very good. Two. Three. Okay, good. Well done. Five more. Weight, you put your weight on your heel. Very good. That's it, that's correct. Last one, please, one more. Oops. Ah, well done. Well done, guy. You know what you're doing. Very good. Okay. So that's it. Your RPE level on the second set, what about?
Yeah, that was eight.
Eight, perfect. Yeah. Okay. Now we're going to move our camera out a bit to this machine. So this is a lat pull down, okay?
Okay.
Lat pull down utilize upper body muscle, not like that machine. This one is when you pull down, you engage your bicep, okay? And your deltoid. And latissimus dorsi, okay? Three muscles, okay? So what you have to do, you got to first adjust the leg seats. You come forward, sit down here. Yeah, this should be snapped on your leg nice and tight. And it should be 90 degree angle on your knee also, okay? You can see from the mirror there, okay? That like this is correct, but if you want to increase the level of this cushion, you can pull this out and bring it back up or down, okay? I'm gonna put it down for myself. Like this, okay? Now check the weight. Is that correct for me?
Yeah.
Okay, that's good. Now step out and grab the bar. It should be 1.5 time outside my shoulder.
Okay.
Actually, I'm gonna reduce it a little bit more. Okay, then we bring it down to our seat. Sitting position. Lean slightly back, okay? And pull this right up to your chest, on the top of your chest. And bring it right up, okay? Exhale as you pull down. Inhale, relax back. Maintain neutral spine, hip, knee, ankle alignment. Keep looking forward, okay? Engage your back muscles. Latissimus dorsi. Hoop. Breathing. Exhale through your mouth. Inhale, okay? Walk around and have a look at the back in the front, how it goes. Go down to the top of your chest, slightly bend, lean back, and pull down and hold. Okay, are you ready to try?
Yes.
Okay, step in. You might have to adjust the seat a little bit. And then the weight, it should be a little bit more than me. Okay, good. Now, 90 degree flexion on your knees. That's good. Okay. 1.5 time. Yeah, that's it. Lean back slightly. Okay. Looking forward, maintain neutral spine. You okay? And then pull it up to the top of your chest. Exhale, inhale. Maintain nice. Throughout, concentric, eccentric. Exhale, inhale. Very good. Three now. We're going to do 10 here, okay? Inhale through your nose, exhale through your mouth. That's it, correct? Okay. Three more. One. Two. And three. Okay, very good, relax. Let's go, yeah. That's it. How's your RPE level?
That was 6 to 7.
Six, yeah, I think, yeah, yes. We should increase weight a little bit. A little bit too easy is for you, right?
Okay,
yeah. We do 10 more, okay? Same thing, okay? You did really well. So just exactly like before. To the top of your chest, breathing nice throughout, eccentric and concentric. That's it. Okay, try to think of the muscle of your back, which is latissimus dorsi. That's it. Not too low, please. Not too low. On the top of your chest. That's it. That's really good. Okay, we do 5 more. And 2 more. Not too low, please. On the top of your chest. That's it. Okay, good. Relax. So how's your RPE level now?
That was like an 8 then.
Good, that's correct. Yeah. Okay, aim around 8, RPE 8.
Good.
Okay, now we're going to do a different exercise. I'm going to grab my board quickly. The next one will be shoulder press.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, let's move the camera to shoulder press area. Oh, somebody using it right now. Okay. Somebody is using the machine right now. So I'm going to come back to the shoulder press later.
Okay.
We're going to do free weight exercise first, which is great. We have our area ready. Yeah, that's it. So free weight exercise we're going to do today is three exercise. First, upright row.
Yes.
Second one, deadlift. And the third one is lateral rest,
okay?
Lateral rest, we need dumbbell. Please, I think with me, I'm going to use 2K. And I think for you, 4K, is that okay? Perhaps you grab this first, otherwise they might not be available later.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Now, let's start with lateral rest first so we can return the dumbbell. Other people can use it. Okay? Okay. With lateral rest, okay, you have feet shoulder width apart, slightly soft on your knees, okay? And brace your core, okay? We're going to lift this weight out on the side of your body, but make sure that you maintain slightly bend on your elbow. Exhale as you come up, inhale as you go down. This lateral rest is aimed on the upper body muscles, okay? Basically, it's just one muscle actually. It's a medial deltoid, okay? Keep looking forward, maintain neutral spine, hip knee ankle alignment, soft knee, brace your core, and come up on the side. Okay, can you walk behind me so you can see? Exhale, inhale. Exhale, inhale. Exhale, inhale. Is that good?
Yep.
Would you like to start to try? Okay. Maybe over here, please, out of the way when people are walking. Okay, I'm gonna check. Yeah, you're still inside the camera angle? That's fine. Okay, now. Bring it up correctly. Yeah, that's it. Soft knee. Maintain neutral spine, hip knee, ankle alignment, looking forward. Brace your core, then bring it out to your side. Okay. Exhale as you bring it up. Inhale through your nose, exhale through your mouth. Three. We're going to do 10 times, okay? Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Well done, guy. You do really, really well. Good job. Good posture. 10. And then, okay, deadlift the weight down. Good. How do you feel? Your RPE level?
I know it's only 4.
Yeah, yeah. Because it's a very small muscle, the medial deltoid. Okay, so don't go too heavy. We gradually. Okay, let's start with 4, and then perhaps in 1 month's time you increase a little bit more weight. Okay. Now, shall we do 10 more?
Yeah.
Good. Okay. Deadlift and grab your bar up to your waist height. That's it. Soft knee. Okay. Hips, knee, ankle alignment. Soft elbow, like slightly bend, and maintain neutral spine. Go for it. 10. Good job. Okay, that's it. 7. Five, four, three, two, and the last one. 1. That's it. Relax. Deadlift the dumbbell down. Well done, guy. Well done. Good job. Good posture. How do you feel?
Yeah, that's quite
the
hard.
Second set is RPE?
Yeah, 8.
8. Perfect. Okay, let's put the dumbbell back. Now, with the upright row, I'm going to stand here. Can you stand over there? Yeah, that's it. Upright row. Upright row, okay? It's an upper body exercise, okay? When you come up, it's engaged trapezius, okay? Deltoid and the bicep. Oh, sorry, tricep. Right, okay? Now, first you look at soft knee, hips, knee, and the shoulder width apart, okay?
Yep.
Now, we deadlift our barbell up.
Yep.
And it should be, your hand should be about thumb width apart. Slightly inside your shoulder, okay, like that. And then when you bring it up, maintain neutral spine, bring it up, elbow nice and high, and then down. Exhale as you come up, and down. Okay, inhale down, exhale up, inhale down. The higher your elbow comes, it's the more engaged of your trapezius, okay? Can you come look behind? Okay,
yeah.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, use this bar, it's fine. Okay. That's it. Okay, first. That's it. Soft knees, shoulder width apart, your feet, shoulder width apart. The thumb width, yeah, that's it. And bring your elbow up. That's it. That's it. Maintain neutral spine. Looking forward, exhale as you come up, inhale down. Okay, exhale, inhale, 3 now, we do 10. Three more. 1, 2, and the last one, guy, you did so well. Well done. Good posture. Well done. Deadlift the barbell down. Now, how do you feel?
Another quite hard
Do you
one.
Feel
yeah.
quite hard on your
yeah.
shoulder,
yeah,
your trap?
I feel it mainly on my shoulders.
Good. RPE level is?
8, 9.
8 or 9. Wow, that's good. Okay, but you will get used to it.
Yeah.
Your body will start to memorize the weight you do, okay? And we increase it like slowly, so that's fine, that's good. So we did already upright row,
one more set.
Lateral rest, okay. One more set of 10.
Second
set, okay. Ready?
Yep.
Okay, go. Go, 1, 2, well done. Elbow up, chest up, brace your core. Soft knee, nice neutral spine. Very good. 3 now. 4, 5, Good. Six. Four more. One. Two. Three. Last one. Very good. Breathing. Exhale and inhale. Last one. Now deadlift the bar down. Good job. How's your RPE?
That was eight that time, yeah. Getting.
Perfect, you did really good job. Next one is a deadlift. Use barbell the same, okay? You can use dumbbell as well, okay? Now we're going to use a little bit heavier weight with the barbell, okay? The deadlift utilize lower body muscles, okay? Gluteal, quadricep, hamstring, and erector spinae, which is your lower back muscle, okay? So I'm going to grab the weight. Grab the weight for you, okay? Hold on.
Oops, sugar.
Okay, here. Maybe here.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so. All right, so you come forward your bar, toward your bar, and put your feet just right under the bar, okay? Right. Soft knee, okay? Now, we're going to put our... Like, put your hand through quadricep. Bring your hands down. Your hand should be just outside your foot.
Yep.
Okay? And bring the barbell upright. Okay? Then you go down. Okay? Should put your hips back. And then move the bar, like, with your leg. Just slightly touch the floor. Then exhale as you come up. Inhale down. Put your hips back. And up. Exhale. Yeah, walk around and have a look. Be careful with the bar, please. I already made mistakes, sorry. Okay. Exhale. You should feel the muscle of your gluteal, your hamstring. That's your main. Okay, are you ready to try?
Yes.
Okay, I'm gonna deadlift that. That's it, okay? Make sure the knees is soft. Yeah, come towards the bar, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, bend your knees, okay? Your hips back, looking. Your head should be in line with your spine.
Okay.
Neutral spines. Okay, good. Now, start your deadlift. Yeah, that's it. One, up. Exhale as you come up. Exhale through your mouth. Inhale through your nose. Two. Three. Good. Your hips back. Be careful. Don't put your knee beyond your toes. Your hips should go back. Five. Six. Maintain neutral spine. Seven. Really good. Your hips go nice and back. Two more, okay? One, okay, you maintain your breathing, good. Okay, last one, that's it. Okay, be careful with your bar, sorry. Okay, how you read your RPE?
Yeah, 7 to 8, I can feel
7 to 8.
As it progresses.
And better. You can feel the target muscles, perfect. We do 10 more, okay? Okay, ready, go. One, yes. Very important to be careful with your back. So soft knee, hips back, brace your core. Exhale as you come up, inhale down. That's it. Good. Up, five more, please. Well done, guy. Very good posture. Very good. Alignments. Three times more. One. Two. And And last one. Okay, great. Then lift your dumbbell down. Okay. Barbell, not dumbbell. How do you feel?
Yeah, good.
Yeah. RPE level?
Yeah, definitely 8.
Well done. Good job. Now we finish with the resistance, free weight exercise. Deadlift done. We have more. Okay, great. Yeah, let's put it away. Okay, we have one resistance machine to do, which is shoulder press. It's over there. Another person still using it. What shall we do?
I think we just go and we wait there.
Okay, let's go and wait over there. Or we can do shoulder press. Okay, that's it. We're going to do shoulder press instead. Okay. Chest press.
I can do that.
Yeah. Yeah. Can you do chest press?
I can try. Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna instruct her the chest press. Okay. So let's sit. Neutral spine, hip. Remain 3-point contract. Okay. Feet, back, neck, head. Okay. We press this one to lift this one up. Lift this bar up.
Yeah.
Push it over. And then you get hold of this,
yeah,
of this handle. Okay, hold on, let me adjust the weight a little bit. This is a chest press. Chest press is pectoral, okay? So it's upper body exercise.
Okay.
So very good to build your pec muscles, okay? So hold it here, okay? Maintain neutral spine, hip. And push it up. Exhale, inhale. Okay, exhale, inhale. Would you like to walk around and see?
Yeah.
Exhale, inhale. Brace your core as you push out and control nice throughout eccentric and concentric. Exhale, inhale. Exhale, inhale, okay? Now,
okay.
Would you like to try?
Yes.
Okay? Now, again, to adjust the weight or you wanna try? You have a try first, see how. Okay, put your, check the feet, the seat, okay? The seat level, okay? Is that too low or too high?
Actually, feels okay.
Okay, great, okay? Now, check the weight, maybe one time, see how is it? Okay, good.
I'll add a little bit more.
Okay, good. Good. Press up, exhale, inhale. Okay, good. Very good. 3, 4. I'm going to walk behind to have a look, okay? Very good guy, well done. Well done. Breathing, exhale, inhale, well done. Exhale through your mouth, inhale through your nose. Brace your core, maintain 3-point contract and neutral spine. Well done. 2 more. Hutch, 1, and last one, 2. Okay, relax. Okay, press the foot down. That's it. How do you feel?
That was 7. I'm going to add
7.
More,
yeah, great, good. And we do 10 more reps.
Okay.
Okay, you understand how the machine works?
Yeah.
Do you feel on your chest?
Yeah.
On your, yeah, good. On your pectoral.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's do 10 more, please. Good. Three. Four. Very good. Maintain neutral spine, hips, knee, ankle alignments. Looking forward, control your breathing. Exhale, inhale. Well done, guy. Okay. Good, okay. Three more. Three. Two. And last one. Good job. Okay. Press on the foot, okay, and relax. Well done. Done. We did the resistance, three resistance machine, okay, and three free weight. One cardio. Now we're going to do cool downs with okay. Equip, and we're going to do with a rower machine. Okay, let's move the camera with us. This piece is a rower machine, okay? It utilizes whole body muscles, okay? Can I show you how to yes. do it first? This seat is a very slippery seat, so be careful, okay? Minimize your accident, like that. Okay, sit properly. Now, put your feet here, but these are, represent a half a size of your shoes, let's say. The number is half a size of your shoes.
Yep.
Okay, now I'm gonna show you, put my feet in. Okay, and yeah, that's correct for me, okay? And pull this strap should go across the widest part of your shoes.
Okay.
Pull it nice and tight. Like that, okay? Now grab the bar, the rower. Now, leg out first, then pull this towards the bottom of your sternum. And leg first, arm, then leg. Legs and arm, then legs. Like that. Maintain neutral spine, keep looking forward. Hips, knee, ankle alignment. Try to make this chain as flat as possible. Okay, and breathing naturally. You shouldn't lean back too much. You should just lean back slightly. Okay. Now, with the cool down, you don't do too hard. You just want to maintain low RPM,
okay.
About 40.
40, okay.
Okay, yeah. With the rower machine, it works a little bit different than other machine. The rower machine might represent a stroke per minute. Okay, should be about, the cooldown should be about 25, okay? If you do use this equipped for cardio, then you might aim on to 30, 35. Okay, now I'm gonna stop now. Are you ready to start?
Yes.
Okay. Press this down to release. Okay, I'm gonna press it down to release. What is your shoe size? 11.
12.
Okay, let's move it down. Adjust it for you, like that. Six?
Yeah. Okay.
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 Be careful with the seat, please. Yeah, it should go across the widest part. That's right. Make it nice and tight. Okay, remember, hold this, and your legs go first, followed by your arm. And your arms should pull this drawer under the sternum. That's it, that's correct. Lean back just slightly, that's it. Maintain neutral spine, keep looking forward, and breathing naturally. That's it. Because it's a cool down section, so we don't do too hard, just keep going. Can you see SPM stroke per minute here? Yep. With the cool down 20, 25 maximum. Finish. That's it, well done. Well done, guy. You did good job. We nearly come to the end of our exercise, okay? With the cool down for the video, we're going to do just 2 minutes, okay? Okay, legs, then arm. Well done, that's it, good job. Okay. How's your RPE on this?
Much more relaxed.
RPE level?
Around 4.
4, perfect, correct. Okay, we're going to slow down a little bit, yeah? Reduce the number here. Yeah, like that. Slow, like that, right down. Okay. I think it's enough, okay? Okay. We finish our cool down. Okay. Then we're going to do stretch. Okay. Yeah, let go of the, that's it. Perfect. Oh, can you grab my board for me, please? Thank you. We're going to do stretch now. Going to quickly do stretch. This is a post-exercise stretch. Okay, let's start with the top upper body stretch first. Okay, I already explained this to you, but I explain again the deltoid. So bring your arm across, okay, and put your arms towards, yeah, use this arm to pull this arm towards your body. That's it, and hold it there for 10 seconds. You should feel a stretch on your deltoid. Okay, and then relax. We do 10 seconds. 10, 15 seconds is enough. Bring your arm across. Put this forearm, pull that arm closer to your body. That's it, and hold it there. 10 seconds. Okay, now relax, okay. Second stretch is tricep stretch. Bring your arms up, put your hands on the back, and then put the other hand, push it toward the back. Okay, I'm going to have a look. That's it, okay, very good. 10 seconds. Good job. Now relax. Relax and do the other arms. That's it. Okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax. Okay, we just did 2 stretch. Now I'm going to do pectoral and latissimus dorsi stretch. So pectoral stretch, pec is chest. So basically, clasp your hand behind your back, okay? Rest your arms up without leaning forward, okay? Soft knees, and rest your arms up, okay? That's it. To maximize the stretch, you deep inhale, and hold it there. That's it, feel the stretch. Hold it there for 10 seconds. That's right, okay. Very good. Okay, relax. Okay, with the latissimus dorsi, this muscle on the side here, soft knee, okay? Now we're going to push this arm up, okay? Make sure you keep your elbow bent, okay? And put through your shoulder. And hold it there 10 seconds. Push it up. And put it through your shoulder, okay? Push it up, and push it through your shoulder. That's it, not your elbow. Okay, well done, that's it. 10 seconds, good job. Now relax, do the other side. Keep your elbow bent. Okay. Very good, guy, very good. Okay, relax, yeah, that's it, okay. With the other two stretch, is one is called adductor stretch, we did it before. Okay, so best knee, best legs, okay, straight and keep pointing two in straight in front of you. Then last step to the side and the toe pointing 45 degrees. Now, lean forward toward these legs and stretch. You can feel stretch on the abductor inner thigh. Here, and hold it there for 10 seconds, okay? Now, last step to the side. Yeah, point the knee, the toes 40 degrees. Lean forward. That's it. Can you feel the stretch? Very good. Keep it there 10 seconds. Okay, come back up, relax. Now come, put your feet together in the center and then step, last step to the other side. Yeah, that's it. Well done, that's it. Okay, well done. When you're ready, come up. The next stretch is gastrocnemius stretch, basically calf stretch, okay? So what you have to do is you step forward, okay? Make sure your heel in line with the toe at the back, okay? So we're going to put your feet flat on the floor, okay? Back feet, try to get it flat on the floor, okay? And lean forward, okay, with your front legs. Make sure the knee doesn't go beyond your ankle, okay? And hold it there for 10 seconds. Don't worry if the back feet cannot be flat. It just have to be, it's to feel the stretch, but not painful. Okay, good, okay. Now do the same thing to the other leg. Can you start? Step, last step forward. Make sure the back toe in line with the front knee. Keep your back leg straight and lean forward. Bend your front legs. Yeah, that's it, go. Your knee doesn't go beyond your ankle. Yeah, that's it. Keep looking straight, keep your body straight. That's it. Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, stop. Okay, come back up and do the other side. Very good, well done, good posture. Very good, very good. And okay, 5 seconds more. 4, 3, 2, stop, come back up. Okay, we did two more stretch already, well done. Last one, hip flexor stretch.
Okay.
This stretch is going to be a little bit different to the other stretch. And this one is developmental stretch. Developmental stretch is basically the same to static stretch, but at the phase two of the stretch. Basically, when you feel the tension on the stretch, you feel the stretch.
Yeah.
After 10 seconds, you create the stretch, when you feel that the tension is gone, you press a little bit more, put a little bit more extra tension onto it, okay? And hold it there for like 30, 50 seconds, okay? So with the hip flexor stretch, we'll take a large step, okay? And put your knees down, okay? Like this, okay? And then you try to put your tailbone behind your hips. Okay, so you feel the stretch on your hips here. Okay, and hold it there. That first phase of the stretch should release after ease off, after 10 seconds. When it's ease off, then you put your hip forward, yeah, slightly. Give a little bit of tension and hold it there for like 30 seconds more. Yeah, walk around and have a look. Okay, like that, and then come up. It's going to hurt your knees a bit or not? You want to do it on the pad? Okay, you sure? Okay, that's it. Now, put your hip forward. Tuck your tailbone under your hips. Can you feel the stretch? Hold it there for 10 seconds. When the tension is eased off, then you put a little bit extra flexion onto it. Yeah, that's it, extra. That's it, good job. And hold it there. 20 seconds more. Good, can you feel stretch? Very good, okay. Yeah, that's enough. Okay, relax. Okay, come up first. Take the last take a step and put your knees down. Okay, now put your hip forward. Feel the tension. Keep it there 10 seconds. It shouldn't hurt you. It just make you uncomfortable. Then put it forward after 10 seconds. Fold your tailbone under your hips and put your hips forward. Yeah, that's it. Okay, hold it there, 30 seconds. Well done, guy, nearly there. 5, 4, 3, 2, finish. Okay, come up. Sorry about the floor, hard floor, sorry. Anyway, how is our exercise today?
That was good.
Yeah, do you like it?
A lot of different things.
You learn lots of things, yes. Yeah. That is will help support your goal on upper body exercise and cardio, lose weight and these kind of things. You just have to keep up with it. Okay, and we come together more time and we develop more exercise and resistance. How is resistance today though?
It varies. Some of them were a real challenge, perhaps because I didn't do it before in that way. So,
yes.
And some were more familiar.
Yeah. If anything that you want to recommend with the exercise or my style of teaching, you can just let me know. Are there anything I can improve, or what you like and what you don't like?
Okay.
Do you have anything you don't like today? Any exercise?
Stretching was new. I don't really do stretching.
Yes.
And I can see that that's helping me get ready for exercise, so perhaps I need to make sure I do that and don't skip it.
Yes, just keep up with your routine,
yes,
and it will make you achieve your goal, okay? And I have to apologize with today, it's too many people, okay? Maybe it's not quite easy.
We did it all,
you,
okay?
Yeah. Are there anything else you want to comment with my style of training, perhaps? Do you like it?
I enjoyed it, actually, because
really?
It's good to be shown how to do it,
okay.
Not just told how to do it. So I can see exactly how you do it, and I can see from the different angles.
Uh-huh.
So I feel quite confident to then go and do it myself in the correct way. And also having the warm-up and the stretching, it does help me feel that I can do something without pulling a muscle or damaging.
Yeah.
Because I've been quite lazy.
Yeah, it's basically make you do exercise correctly,
yeah.
Reduce the chance of having injured, and correctly build up the muscle without damage it, yeah. Instead. Well done, Kai. You did so well today, I have to say. Your cardio is good. You already have good performance on the cardio exercise, and you have some knowledge on the resistance machine, which is really good. And you do it all correct. Very good. Well done. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
All right, thank you. Finish my video today. Thank you.